Good morning, children. I hope you all are fine.
Yes.
Children, today I'm going to do power resources, children. See, in the previous class, we have studied about minerals, different kinds of minerals, and where these minerals are found throughout the world, and why should we conserve the minerals, we have studied, children. Yes? Yes. Today, let us study about power resources. See, children, before I start my lesson, I would like to tell you, you first imagine there is a power cut in your area for 2 days. And what is, mention some of the problem you would face in the absence of power supply, children. The first thing is, these days you are all doing online classes, so your mobile recharging and your laptops, your computers does not work at all if there is no power. First thing. Second thing is, there won't be light at home, your fridge will not work, your iron box will not work, your geyser will not work. So all these type of problems will arise if there is no power for 2 days. You will have to face lot of problem, children. So, before we start our lesson, I would like to tell you how these power resources are being generated. We are going to study, children, today. See, we need energy or power to run machines. What do we need? We need energy or power to run machines, light our homes, and use different means of transport also, children. The resources which are used to generate this power of energy are known as power resources. They are known as power resources. Some examples of power resources are, you have studied from the beginning, I have been telling you, coal, natural gas, and petroleum. These are all called as fossil fuel. It is non-renewable resources, children. It cannot be renewed, I have been telling you. So, power resources can be categorized as conventional, conventional resources and non-conventional resources, children. Okay, this is conventional and non-conventional resources, children. See, when I say conventional power resources, it is conventional power resources, non-conventional power resources, children. When I say conventional power resources, that has been in use for a long period of time are called as conventional power resources, and they have limited reserves and they are exhaustible. They are exhaustible in the nature, children. Example, just now as I told you, coal, petroleum, natural gas, firewood and hydro power are some of the examples. The same here, and the extra one is hydro power here. Even this joins along with this three, children. Coal, natural gas, petroleum and hydro power are examples of conventional power resources, children. So today, let us take about the first one, coal. Under conventional power resources, under conventional power resources, we have the first one, coal. So let us know about coal today, children. See, coal is obtained from decayed plants which got buried under sediments thousands of years ago, and it is also known as fossil fuel. It is also known as fossil fuels from decayed plants. Okay, children, coal is being called as fossil fuel. It is being formed in the form of decayed plants thousands of years ago. It is also known as fossil fuel. It is the most abundantly found fossil fuel. It is used to run machines. Machines and then steam engines. Got it, children? It is also called as fossil fuel. It is being formed from the decayed plants, and it is used in machines, steam engines, and ships also. And ships, children. So this is how it is being generated, and it is used to generate even electricity also. Generate electric city. It is used to generate electricity or for thermal power. See, children, it is used to generate electricity or thermal power. There are four varieties of coal. In coal, four varieties are there, children. What are those? The first one is peat. The second one is lignite. Bituminous is the third one. Bituminous and the fourth one is anthracite. Out of these, the best variety of coal is anthracite. While the most widely available is bituminous, lignite and peat are inferior varieties of coal. These are inferior varieties of coal, children. See, under conventional power resources, we have got coal, petroleum, natural gas, hydropower, firewood. So the first one we have taken here is coal. It is also called as fossil fuel. It is being made by decayed plants, and it is used for machines, steam engines, and ships. And it is also used to generate electricity or thermal power. There are four varieties of coal. The first one is peat, the second one is lignite, and the third one is bituminous, and the fourth one is anthracite. So now, the most famous and most available, widely available coal is anthracite, children. It is the best variety of coal, that is anthracite. Understand, children? So this is about coal, and the major producers of coal are China, USA, Russia, Ukraine, South Africa, India, Australia and Germany children.
See, it is found in all these countries in the world. That is, the first one is China, USA, Russia, UK, South Africa, India, Australia and Germany children. These are the places where coal is being majorly found, and they are the producers of coal. In India, coal is found in
Damodar River Valley. Damodar River Valley children.
It has been found in Damodar River Valley. The main coal mining areas are Jharia, Dhanbad, Girith, Bukharo and Raniganj. So these are the places where they are found in India children. Understand now? This is about the conventional power resource. The first one is coal. I have now when we move on to petroleum.
Did you all understand children about the coal? See the points what I have written on the board. You please go through it. You will recall.
Yes, the second one is petroleum. See, when I say petroleum, you will all be knowing about petrol. Without petrol, your vehicles, your transportation cannot move at all. So, petroleum is also called as fossil fuel. It is also called as fossil fuel children. And that which is trapped in layers of
sedimentary rocks. Coal, I have told you, decayed plants.
So here it is, sedimentary rocks in the form of black liquid.
In the form of
black liquid it is formed, and it is also known as black gold. It is also known as black gold, and it is drilled from oil fields found in the coastal and offshore regions. After extraction, it is taken to refineries and to refine to produce a large number of products like petrol, diesel, kerosene and lubricants. You know lubricant oils which they use for vehicles and for machines also children. The main petroleum producing countries are
Saudi Arabia, Kuwait,
Iraq,
Iran,
UAE, Qatar and Bahrain. See, all these are Saudi countries only children where petroleum is being produced, and even in some parts of the other countries it is being produced like USA, Russia, China, Venezuela, Egypt, Libya, Algeria, India, Indonesia and Myanmar children. So in India it is produced at Bombay High in Mumbai, Dig Boy in Assam and in the deltas of Krishna and Godavari rivers. Understand children? Krishna and
Godavari rivers. See, I have told you,
coal is being found on the beds of Damodar River Valley. Understand? So the main areas is Jharia, Dhanbad, Girith, Bukharo and Raiganj in India, coal. Petroleum, it is Mumbai, Digboy in Assam and in deltas of Krishna and Godavari rivers, children. So today, I'll end up my class with these two topics. If you have any doubts, children, tomorrow in my live class, I'll clear all your doubts. Thank you, children. There is a few question and answers and a small worksheet will be given to you all. Work it out. Thank you once again. Have a nice day. Thank you, children.